pretty brutal. You guys have it so easy because of the internet. You'll have every song on your fingertips. Now to bacha, you'll have all this Spotify and all of that.
It's Spotify, Daddy.
Bacha, that okay. The hardships we had to face in our days, we used magnetic tape recorders and these weren't even available that easily.
I know, Daddy.
Sound technology has evolved considerably over the years. There was a generation of recording techniques such as the wax cylinders and the classic LPs, but they did not offer that much sound quality. But when the magnetic tape recorders entered the industry, they ruled the studios for years to come and still have an impact on us till today. Fritz Fluemer invented magnetic tape in 1920. His invention was based on the magnetic wire recording technique invented by Waldemar Paulsen in the year 1890. Fritz later granted his patent to AEG, a German company, for making a practical magnetic tape recorder called the magnetophone cable. Then later it was fitted with ring-shaped tapes by Edward Schuller and by BSL, and it debuted at the Berlin Radio Fair in 1935. Later, the model sound quality was enhanced. It reached Britain, where the London Philharmonic Orchestra was recorded for the very first time. Special models were made for the German Navy. The sound quality of the sound recorders even allowed Adolf Hitler to fool people into believing that he was giving live broadcasts from a city while he was somewhere else. The Americans took the magnetophones after the World War II and reinvented the reel technology. The company Ampex was formed in 1946, and then the music and the film industries became aware of this piece of technology, and this was the beginning of the professional audio recording. After the company Ampex was established, a new feat was achieved when a live radio show was recorded using the Ampex 200 reel-to-reel magnetic tape recorder. In the 1950s, Swiss mechanic Will Studer created the compact tape recorder. Then, in the year 1955, Mr. Les Paul, the inventor of the solid body electric guitar, invented multi-track recording. Ultimately, multi-track recording was used by artists such as the Beatles in the 1960s, making it one of the most important innovations of the 20th century. At the Abbey Road Studios, the Beatles recorded their classic Sgt. Pepper's using this multi-track recorder, the J37. In the end, multi-track recorders became 4-track, 8-track, and finally settling down on the 24-track records.
But how was the magnetic tape recorder made? Well, the first part is the magnetic tape itself. The recording medium for the tape recording process is typically made by embedding tiny magnetic oxide particles in a plastic binder on a polyester film tape. The emulsion used is usually iron oxide. These particles are shaped like tiny needles and cover about 400 million per inch. The oxide particles themselves do not move during recording. Rather, their magnetic domains are reoriented by the magnetic field from the tape head. They are on the order of 0.5 micrometers in size, and the polyester tape backing may be as thin as 0.01 millimeter. Now, the second part of the recorder is the electromagnet. It is extremely small in size, consisting of an iron core wrapped with wire. The basic tape head action involves an oscillating current in a coil. The magnetic field produced in a ring of ferromagnetic material fringes out to the tape material at the gap. Putting all those components together, we have a magnetic tape recorder.
But how does this works? Let's see. A magnetic tape recorder has five basic components: recording head, reproducing head, transport mechanism, conditioning devices, and magnetic head. Isn't this familiar? This is the tape. It is a plastic material and its one side is covered with a magnetic material. Now, what is the use of this magnetic material? Now, as the tape passes from one of the reels, it reaches a magnetizing head, which is the recording head. Now, this recording head impresses a residual magnetic pattern upon it in response to an amplified input signal. The recording head consists of a core, a coil, and there is a fine air gap between the head, the recording head, and the magnetic tape. Now, the coil current creates a flux which magnetizes the iron oxide particles of that tape. Now, here is the actual recording which takes place between this air gap. The transport mechanism assures that this magnetizing tape will move at a constant speed below these magnetizing heads and without any strain or any kind of distortion.
Now,
the tape reaches the reproducing head. An output voltage is generated across the coil of the reproducing head, which is proportional to the magnetic flux of that magnetic tape. Thus, the magnetic pattern in the tape is detected and then converted back into original electrical signal.
Before you rush to the store to buy a magnetic tape recorder, I feel you should know a few pros and cons about it.
Tape recorders are inexpensive and can store up to 1 terabyte of data. They are compact and easy to store, provided suitable environment. Now, you need a key to open a lock, right? Similarly, the tape recorder cannot be played without an external tape drive. And if you've seen this video carefully, you must have noticed that the tape recorder consists of a coating which is magnetizable. So you cannot place it near a strong magnetic field because it will corrupt your data. And you wouldn't want that, would you? So tape recorders are a pretty reliable tool as long as it is not damaged.
Arey puttar, you guys don't know more than me.
See Dadi, although magnetic tape recorders were replaced by digital recorders in the 90s, it still holds a place in history.
Okay, bacha, okay.